I often give updates on strange stars on this channel that have no ready explanation, such as Boyajian's star and the possibility that it might indicate alien activity. But there is another star that may also be an indicator of an alien civilization that's currently making the rounds on several science blogs, links in the description below, and it may even be a better candidate for being a potential detection of alien life than Boyajian's star. The difference between the two is that while KIC 8462852's strange dimming events could indicate alien megastructures blocking light from the star, that's probably not the case. See the other videos dedicated to that star on this channel. It's much more likely that what we're actually seeing is an incredibly rare natural event, such as the star recently having ingested a planet. But while the explanation for Boyajian's star is going to be interesting, whatever it might be, it's probably going to be a variant of something we've seen before or expected to be going on in the universe, and won't require a rethink of a whole area of science. The circumstances of this other star, however, are very different. Now, I tend to try to get the naming of the celestial objects I talk about on this channel as correct as I can get them, or I simply default to the official catalog numbers if there is ambiguity surrounding it. After all, KIC 8462852 is also known as the WTF star, Tabby star, Boyajian star, the alien megastructure star, and so on, though it seems to be settling on Boyajian star as a matter of giving proper scientific naming credit to the lead investigator. But with this star, I fall completely short. This star does have an accepted name, and I apologize to any Polish speakers in the audience in advance. The pronunciation for this star is all over the place on the internet, and the best I could do was ask a person I know that speaks a bit of Polish. I'm told that something close to the proper pronunciation for this star is Przybylski's star. I'm sure I got that wrong. Polish words are about as tough to pronounce as it gets for native English speakers. But at least I didn't chicken out and tried. But for the sake of clarity, I will run and hide for the rest of the video and use the catalog name for this star, which is HD101065. But we could also call this star the Plutonium star because it apparently contains it, along with a bunch of other ultra-heavy elements that are both highly unstable and very short-lived. Those should not be there, and can mean one of three things. Elements exist that we did not really expect to see in nature. The detection of ultra-heavy elements is a mistake. Or aliens made them artificially and dumped them into the star. Now, these elements are at the very end of the periodic table, a mysterious place where we know comparatively little about the chemistry of the transuranic elements, and some of them have only relatively recently been synthesized artificially in the lab. Outside the lab, we see these elements, so far, nowhere in the universe other than this type of weird star. In fact, these heavy elements are so far up the table that some physicists and chemists are skeptical that they can exist in nature and can only be artificially synthesized. Given that they seem present in this star means that we either need to rethink the mechanisms for which heavy elements can be produced in nature, or we must consider the possibility that aliens put them there. HD 101065 is chemically weird in many ways. First studied in 1961 by the aforementioned Polish-Australian scientist whose name is in the title of the video, apologies to him, and his original paper is also listed in the description, the star features very low iron and nickel, but comparatively high amounts of heavy elements like thorium and uranium. Now, these do occur in nature, so it's really the ratios that are strange. But it also seems to contain actinide elements heavier than uranium that don't make a whole lot of sense for being there. These include, reportedly in ascending order, americium, curium, berkelium, only about 1 gram of that element has ever been created on Earth, californium, and einsteinium. There's some ambiguity as to whether those are really there, only more study will clear that up. But also present are the lighter but still radioactive elements technetium, which has no stable isotopes and is extremely rare in nature, but may be related to the presence of the uranium, and promethium, which also has only radioactive isotopes, plus lots of other rare elements that you don't hear much about. Yet HD 101065 has them in comparative abundance, apparently impossibly so. In fact, as Jason Wright of Pennsylvania State University notes in his blog, this star has more praseodymium, how often do you hear about that element, than iron. This could be somewhat illusory, however. Dr. Wright details how those elements might get concentrated in the star's atmosphere in layers due to the very strong, somewhat mysteriously so, magnetic fields of this type of peculiar star. I highly recommend those wishing to dig deeper into this story check out his blog and the other related materials, which I have included links and citations for in the description below. So how do all of these strange elements end up in a star's upper atmosphere? A 2008 paper by Vera Gopka and colleagues, link below, details that they might be produced by a nearby neutron star. Trouble is, HD 101065 does not appear to have a nearby neutron star. Strike that explanation. The next explanation has to do with the periodic table. Now here is where we get into scientific rethink territory. The heavy actinide elements do not like to exist. The nuclei of these atoms are truly huge and essentially fall apart or decay into more stable atoms, releasing energy along the way. This allows you to do interesting things, such as easily split atoms of uranium. This yields nuclear energy, but also unfortunately allows for the creation of nuclear weaponry. But above the unstable actinides, there is hypothesized to be what is called the island of stability, where there could be more stable but really heavy atoms. We've never seen any of these yet, but the nuclear physicists do keep synthesizing heavier and heavier elements, and seem set to eventually explore this area of the periodic table and confirm the properties of these atoms. But a paper from March 13th by V.A. Dzuba and colleagues proposes that such elements might be produced in a certain type of supernova, and that the weirdness of HD 101065 might be the result of the decay of more stable but still radioactive elements located in the island of stability, leading to all of these short-lived unstable actinides and rare elements. If this is the case, it would be revolutionary for both nuclear physics and chemistry that such elements could exist in nature. But I suspect that this one will be contentious because conventional thinking has been that these elements are not likely to be present in nature. And a further question would be that if a supernova was responsible, where is all the iron that is normally associated with supernovas? So to explain this star, we must rely on hypothetical elements decaying after being created by a hypothetical mechanism that counterintuitively didn't seem to produce much iron, or that iron is somehow obscured in the star's makeup. Messy indeed. And that leads us into alien origin territory. In 1980, Daniel Whitmire and David Wright, again citations below, advanced a rather extraordinary proposition. They suggested that a civilization using nuclear energy might dump the waste into their star. The problem with this, though, is that it seems unlikely that a civilization with the ability to dump that waste into their star would still be using nuclear fission, but instead would have moved on to fusion. After all, we're getting close to that ourselves, and within 100 years, fission as an energy source seems likely to go obsolete. That takes us to another possibility. In 1966, Sagan and Schklovskii suggested that one way to announce your presence to the universe is to dump a bunch of artificial elements into your star. They might rightly assume that other civilizations in varying stages of advancement would be doing astronomy and actively looking at the spectra of stars. So rather than blast out huge, energy-consuming radio signals, it might be simpler to use the heavy elements to inform others that they are not alone. That doesn't really convey much information, unfortunately, but if it turns out that the island of stability elements cannot be naturally created, then this will be one of the biggest stories in the history of science. In the end, however, it's always safest to assume that a natural explanation will eventually be found, and aliens are a very broad explanation and always the least likely. If you have to bet, bet on nature. But out of all of the weird, potential alien-related material that I cover on this channel, this is the weirdest I have yet seen. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently inching closer to opening my second channel, which will focus on science fiction. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.